saw that presence, a glimpse of it every game last year. If we can get that kid on the floor, good thing it's going
to
happen.
Yeah, he's a double-double waiting to happen. And as I said, everybody else just can play off him. But he's got to stay on the floor. But you're right. Now they've got depth to bring some big guys in if that happens.
So it'll be Anderson and Kennedy to jump center for their squads. Rochester will go right to left. Obviously, the Cavaliers left to right. The ball is up in the middle circle. And the tip controlled by Sanders in the backcourt. Now gives to Trent Elliott, who's on his way to Fairmount State in West Virginia to D2, a full-ride scholarship. That's special.
Cleaver's open up in man-to-man, which is something we didn't see a lot of. Coach wanted to get back to the man-to-man this year with more depth, not have to play that zone. And Cleaver start out in it right away.
And Elliott will fire a three right wing. It's up by the bottom of the net. And Elliott up. I should say Culver up. Now 3-0 with 30 seconds gone in the opening quarter. And Culver will come out a 2-3 zone. It's almost like a trapping 2-3 zone, right?
Yep, they're going to trap on the wings and chase and make Rochester move the ball.
Kennedy's 17-footer draws nothing but air. The putback by Abbott is good. And now Coach Elliott says run. Trent Elliott, 3 on the way right side, is short. And the rebound is hauled in by Brett, who gets ahead to Garrick. Garrick, left side of the ring. Floor, that is. Got a hollow between the ring. Now, let's street. Free zone by the Cavalier defense. 3-2 Culver here. A minute gone to the first quarter of the guys' basketball season. Abbott. Stands, gives to Streeton. He drives the paint, kicks it in the corner to Kennedy. Now, quickly to Holland. To Brett Abbott behind the arc, left side. Right wing pass to Holland. Holland dribbles out and gives a screen quickly left side to Abbott, looking for Garrick in the baseline. Can't get him. Good defense there by Elliott at the free throw line to Kennedy. He loses the basketball, but he does go on a reach-in foul by Sanders, and it'll be out of bounds to Rochester.
Nice play by Zebra, stretching the floor with a four-guard offense, and something I've seen in practice and in the scrimmage is Luke Kennedy expanding his game, being able to go to that 15-foot range. He gets a catch, and he can move the offense that way, or he can catch and shoot there, too.
Boy, if he can start knocking down that 15-footer, that mid-range shot, look out. Holland is fouled on the drive by Jordan Sanders, so Coach Elliott's going to have to go to the bench quickly, and he'll send in Alex Graham, a 5'9 junior for the Cavaliers. So we're at 6.5 to play in the first quarter, and Jordan Sanders has just picked up foul number two.
Just again, those scenarios of A through Z, you think about as a coach in the opener, you don't think your starting guard's going to pick up two fouls in the first minute and a half.
Street looks to get the basketball inbound. Bounce pass into Holland. It stands high on the right side. Holland out directs traffic against the Cavalier 2-3 zone. Left side to Street, quickly to Abbott. Abbott inside the arc, now at the three-throw line. Leaner in the paint is on the way. It's good. Brett Abbott has all four of the Zebra points, and they're up 4-3 with 6:15 to play in the first quarter.
Abbott is a sophomore, just pretty much a JV player last year, but battled a hand injury that I think limited his progress. This year gives him another athlete to be able to penetrate and give another dynamic guard out on the wing.
Rochester in a man-to-man defense. Anderson backs his way in, throws up a shot off the glass. It's good and a foul. And just like we talked about, almost on cue, Luke Kennedy picking up fouls last year, not being able to stay on the floor, and foul number one of the season goes to Luke.
Yeah, and that's, again, the first game thing, as good as solid as the team Rochester has and goes 10 deep, there's nobody on the practice floor that can simulate what Dakota Anderson can do.
You're right.
And that's a tough matchup for Luke Kennedy. He hasn't seen that in practice.
Free throws good by Anderson, and the Cavaliers back up 6-4 with under 6 minutes to play in the first quarter. And now Culver will switch to a man-to-man defense. The screen works to the right wing, not the volleyball line. Now left side to Holland. Alex studies. Working against Hansel. Now down low to Kennedy. Fakes a shot. Goes up over Anderson. Shot is short. Ball tipped out and rebounded by Kruger. And he pushes up the floor. Kruger through the center circle. Right side to Elliott. Elliott stops to his left side. It's between his legs. Dribble. Kicks it outside to Kruger. Between the rings. Back to Elliott right wing. Looking for Anderson. Feeds it down low. And Kennedy's going to come over the back of Dakota Anderson and pick up his second foul.
One of those where coaches probably going to tell him, hey, Luke, especially with one foul, you gotta be a little bit smarter than that. This is your senior year. You got to think about your foul situations. If Anderson was going to catch that ball, he would have been two steps off the block. That would have been okay. He did not have deep post position. Luke's got to understand that, and he knows that. But this is, again, those first game situations, and Taylor Medina comes in, hopefully can provide a solid post presence.
Elliott for three, short. And the rebound is straight. And the neat thing about now when kids go to the bench, and I'm not saying he didn't have that last year, is Abbott runs to the baseline, cut off by the defense, and the ball is kicked away. It'll stay with Rochester. Now you got Dan Bailey, you got Sean Kelly, you got Chris Holm, you got Joe McCarter on the bench telling him, that exact thing you just told me.
Right, and you've also got versatility. It's almost like a five-guard lineup now. Medina gives you that inside-outside presence.
Yeah.
This could be a lineup where you might see some pressure, some extended kind of defense that can maybe get a little more up-tempo this year, too.
Anderson guarding Streeton, and we're going to have a offensive foul on the Rochester Zebras. So that's a turnover on the Zebras, and Culver going to get it back up by two with 5:06 to play in the first quarter.
The foul's going to be on Medina. He was trying to set a screen, so Cutter can go across the paint, but he kind of leaned into that a little bit. You can maybe get away with that in soccer, but you can't get away with that in basketball when you're right in front of the official.
Or contact is welcome.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the JV game tonight, Culver defeated Rochester 30-21 in a pretty good basketball game. Weston Bush and Josh Krissick had 10 for the Cavaliers. Sam Adams led the Sabres with 8 in that first game of the regular season. So Elliott runs top of the key, runs the point against Garrick. Spinner in the lane all the way. He's fouling the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's going to be a tough matchup for Rochester. Elliott can play inside, outside, take people off dribble and shoot. Garrick, I'm not sure he has the speed to keep up with him. They're going to have to send help. And then in that situation, when you send help, you got to make sure you're helping with your feet, not reaching with your hands.
Well, and if they send somebody that's quicker, Trent Elliott then has 6 advantage.
Mm-hmm. And he's a good passer, willing passer, good ball handler. Just and there's a reason why he's getting his education paid for via basketball. That's
yeah,
for sure.
Right. Elliott makes the first free throw to push the lead to 3. The senior will have one more, and he hits both of them. 8-4 Culver with under 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Culver Community High School tonight as we open, as we do every year, the high school basketball season the night before Thanksgiving. Abbott high on the right side against the man-to-man defense. He works against Krueger for the Cavaliers. Abbott now pass to Holland at the volleyball line. We're right side, now left side to Garrick. Works against Elliott. Now to Streeton behind the arc, left side. Streeton drives to elbow, out to Holland. He'll fire a long three. It's off the back of the rim, no good. Anderson skies for the rebound, grabs it, gives to Elliott. Elliott, left side of the floor for the Cavaliers. Hesitates, now accelerates, goes to the baseline. Step back jumper from 15 feet is good. 10-4 Culver, 4:10 to play in the first quarter. Streeton, top of the key, left side to Holland. Man-to-man defense by the Cavaliers. Rochester in the road black with gold numbers and letters. Streeton works against Graham. Works right side of the free throw line. In the paint now, kicks it out to Garrick. Garrick against Elliott. Backs his way to the block on the left side, and he's going to be, called for travel. And Trent Elliott literally in the jersey of Garrick, and he's called for a walk.
Trent Elliott reacted like he thought he was going to get a foul call. Coach Elliott acted like he was going to get a foul call. But the most important opinion in the gym is the guy in the stripes, and he saw that as a travel. Bad break for the Zebras.
3:40 to play, first quarter. Culver up 10-4. Elliott through the center circle, works right side to Krueger. Krueger against Streeton. Rice takes him to the baseline. Stops, loses a shot. It's good. That leader goes for about 5 feet. It's 12-4. And right now, Culver on a 9-4 or 9-0 run. If that ball is tipped out of bounds, it'll stay with Rochester right in front of the Culver student body on the far side of the gym.
You know, there's no doubt Rochester a little more athletic than they were last year, but Culver looks the more athletic team right now.
Yeah.
A little quicker off the dribble. The Zebras are about a step slow, and Culver taking advantage in dribble penetration.
Abbott right side, drives the lane, throws up a shot, blocked out of bounds by Anderson, and it'll stay with Rochester baseline right.
That's one thing to get the shot blocked, but the other thing that does is sets up that seed of doubt in the mind of the offensive players the next time they go in, see if they're hesitant, if they back away from that shot, or if they keep going. Sometimes one block shot then discourages the next few.
So Rochester has it. Garrick, right side, hesitates, goes to the rack. Leaner on the way off the window is no good. A foul on the play. And Alec Garrick will go to the line to shoot two for, it was before the shot, so it'll be out of bounds for Rochester baseline right.
Foul starting pile up a little bit. That's the 7th one of the game as Coach Reinhold takes timeout.
It'll be a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's Table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3:11 to play in the first quarter. The Cavaliers at Culver Community High School 12-4. And the Rochester Zebras have taken a 30-second timeout to calm the troops a little bit. In case you're just joining us, Luke Kennedy already on the bench. You get two personal fouls, and Taylor Medina, the 6-foot junior, in the game for Rochester. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. It'll be Rochester basketball to bounce baseline right. Streeton will look to trigger it in. Streeton looks, studies, lofts it in over the defense to Garrick, who stands near the volleyball line on the right side of the floor. Garrick, crossover dribble in the paint, floater on the way, is going to be no good, but a foul coming on Culver. And it looks like Alex Graham will pick up that foul, and Alex Garrick will this time go to the free throw line to shoot two.
That'll be Graham's second, team's fourth. Again, full teams with four fouls here. Maybe looking at some early free throws here in the first half.
Two of Coach Elliott's guards in foul trouble right now. Garrick will make that Holland a long three. Goes and breaks the scoreless drought. And pulls Zebras within five with under 3 minutes to play in the first quarter.
That's a big weapon. Zebras going to have to be able to knock down some threes from outside shots to open up either the post game or the drive game this year.
2-3 zone for the Zebras. Left side is Graham. Graham's pass is deflected, but right into the hands of Hansel. Hansel has his pass knocked away. Anderson has it now. Anderson, leaner off the window, no good. A foul coming on Rochester. Boy, that helter-skelter play worked perfectly for Culver. And that's going to send Dakota Anderson to the line to shoot two for the Cavaliers.
Fine line for the Zebras. It looked at the point that Anderson was going to get called for the travel, but he regained his composure. And then the lean-in looked like Zebras could have taken a charge, but slid in a little bit. That's going to be Brett Abbott's first team fifth.
Actually, it was a whistle before the shot, so it'll be called for a basketball to bounce baseline left as the inbound pass comes into Elliott. High on the left side for the Cavaliers. Rochester in a 2-3 zone, a 2.5 minutes play in the first quarter. Elliott is going to be tied up, and it's going to go to the Rochester Zebras.
Nice job. A little different look for the Zebras on defense. Alec Holland getting in front of Trent Elliott, getting the assignment there. Hopefully match up the quickness and then sending Carter Screen in for help. Carter did a nice job, get a tie-up. Zebras get the ball.
Streeton all the way into the paint. Kicks out to Holland on the right wing. Left side now to Abbott. Fakes left, now goes right at the free throw line. Accelerates in the paint. Kicks out to Streeton. Now top to Holland. Holland back to Streeton, right side. Looking down low to Garrick, who is being guarded tightly by Elliott. Now back to Holland in the center circle with 2 minutes to play in the first quarter. Culver by five. Holland works to the right wing. Now in the right corner to Abbott. Looking down low to Medina. Can't find him. Out the elbow, right to Garrick, back to Streeton. Streeton drives the travel before he goes to the right. And it'll go back to Culver. And in the game for the first time for Rochester will be Dominic Thomas, the 6-foot junior. And also into the game will be Noah Dahlquist, the 6'4 junior for the Rochester Zebras. Brett Abbott comes out of the game, as does Taylor Medina.
Yeah, Zebras pretty big now. You've got a front line of Thomas, Garrick, and Dahlquist on the back line of that zone. And then Streeton and Holland in at the guard spots.
As you heard Coach Reinholt say in the pregame interview, the Dahlquist wingspan is amazing. It is long. So Rochester in a 2-3 zone. Elliott back door to Anderson. Then throw to Elliott. Dunk two. The lob and the dunk. Nice feed by Elliott. Great finish by Anderson. See how far Anderson is above the rim.
Had to look up. Almost lost him in the lights.
Garrick shot partially blocked. Anderson with it now. Now ahead to Hansel. Now to Elliott. Elliott just back pass to Berger. And before the pass, I believe we're going to have a foul on the Rochester Zebras.
I think that foul is going to be on Carter Street in transition on the floor. If it is on Carter, that's his first, team six. So Culver's going to shoot throws the rest of the way on any foul by Rochester.
1:15 to play in the first quarter. Culver by seven. Inbounds pass goes into Kruger, right-handed layup. Rebound to Dahlquist, ahead to Holland. Holly, right side, stops, pops at the elbow. Good. Holland has five, and it's 14-9. Culver.
That's a nice move. Obviously, didn't want part of Anderson in five, but quick pull-up jumper. He gets the big man back on his heels, clear over him, and that's another part of Alec Holland's game that's going to be very valuable, that mid-range game.
50 seconds to play for Culver, leading 14-9. I believe Anderson has thoughts of going back door to Elliott. But that up gives Elliott left side, quick three for the Cavs. Yep. 17-9. That's smooth, isn't it?
Yep, 10 points in the quarter for Mr. Elliott.
Garrick high on the left side, looking for Thomas down low. But gives the screen, who swings right side to Holland. 2-3 zone by the Cavaliers. Holland one dribble now left side to Garrick. 22 seconds to play first quarter. Culver up by eight. Treaton, right side to Holland with 18. Down the corner to Garrick with 17. On the baseline, drives, cut off by the double team. Takes it out to Holland with 14. Holland high on the right side, back to Garrick with 10. Garrick gives it Dom in the paint. He throws the ball to the baseline, picks up a screen off the leg of screen out of bounds with 4.3 to play in the first quarter. And Culver will have a final shot of the period, up by 8. Anderson gives to Elliott. Across the timeline with 2. Elliott at the buzzer, on the way. We're going to have a travel before the buzzer with a half a second to play.
And Carter is hoping to pick up a foul on Elliott there. He looked in pretty good position to take a charge. He had a good read on what Elliott was going to do. Referee may have taken the safe call there and called travel, and then either player gets a foul.
0.5 seconds to play first quarter. It's going to be a catch and shoot. Screen will trigger it in. Streeton's got to get it in. Holland, three-quarter at the buzzer. No good, off the backboard. After one, Culver leads 17-9. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed Satellite Internet Service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option that Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Second quarter here at Culver Community High School. The Cavaliers leading 17-9. We'll start the second period of the basketball. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Back into the game is Jordan Sanders, a 5'6 senior who started this game but had to leave and watch most of the first quarter because of foul trouble.
And for the Zebras, Brandon Camp checks in for the first time. Senior guard. Zebras kind of extending their zone a little bit, not really trapping out of it, just extending and covering more territory.
Sanders crosses the timeline, works left side, bounce pass to Kruger. Kruger against that, looks like that trapping zone, gives to Elliott. He'll fire a three, it's short, and the rebound to Rochester Garrick, but I believe Anderson came up over the back.
That's Anderson's first, team's fifth.
So Rochester will get it back, down by 8. And it looks like Culver will be...
I think they're matching up man-to-man.
Yeah. As Holland crosses through the center circle, and Hansel will pick him up there. Abbott back into the game. Now to Camp, back to Abbott. High on the left side, back to Holland on the right wing. Holland drives in the paint. Leaner on the way is blocked by Culver. And the ball tipped around, and Kruger comes out of there for the Cavaliers. Kruger spins away from the defense. Now to Sanders. 2-3 zone by the Zebras. Sanders around the defense. Middle of the floor, left side to Elliott. Oh. Elliott dribbles near the timeline. Elliott now directs traffic, works right side. Behind his back dribble, gives to Sanders in the center circle. Under 7 minutes to play first half. Sanders in the corner to Kruger. Kruger passes up a three to gives a wide open Elliott. He'll fire a three. Good. I believe that's his third three of the game, and it's 20-9.
You're right. That's the 13th point of the game.
6:40 to play first half. 2-3 zone now by the Cavaliers. Abbott, left side. Down the corner to Garrett.
I'm just a little unsure, I think, of where they're at. You've got some new faces here. Abbott, Dahlquist, and Camp playing their first varsity experience. Everybody's not quite sure what to do against the zone.
Anderson gets the pass, taken away. Now by Holland. Holland on a 3-1 break. Bounce pass down low to Abbott. His chip layup is good. Nice hit by Alex Holland to strip the ball away from Anderson.
Didn't think you could slap the backboard, but maybe nobody saw it. I don't know.
I didn't see it. I heard it.
Nice play by Holland to start that break. That was a great steal.
Elliott, no-look pass down low to Anderson. Off his head's out of bounds.
That's probably what Coach Elliott's a little concerned about. The game's kind of, you know, he got a comfortable lead. He does not want his team playing loose and, you know, worked really hard and played really well to get this lead. Coach Elliott probably says, hey, guys, let's make the easy plays. Let's not try to make the Sports Center highlight reel every time down the floor.
They've already had one of those tonight, in case you're just joining us. A backdoor alley-oop to Dakota Anderson. Two-handed slam, finish that drive. 5:40 to play, first half. 9-point lead by the Cavaliers. Kennedy back in the game for Rochester. Abbott in the paint, stop, and he's going to travel. He drew traffic, that's for sure, in the lane. Drew about three defenders, and he's going to be in a bit of trouble.
Maybe a little hesitant looking to see where Mr. Anderson was in the paint.
Can't blame
you guys are, but with Luke in the game, you've got that low post threat. If you can get him to help up, Luke's going to be open for layups. Now, Luke's got to be smart on this end and not pick up that third foul.
Yeah, right. Pass is tipped away. Ball loose. Anderson comes up with it. Ball still loose. It's a scrum. Kennedy now has it. Now Sanders for Culver has it.
Oh.
And now it's taken away by Holland. Picked up by Sanders. Behind his back dribble. Culver with the numbers. Sanders middle of the floor. Picks away through traffic. And he's going to be stopped by passing by Alex Holland. There could have been about five fouls in that sequence.
Oh, yeah. At least. That foul is going to be, I think, on Alex Holland. That's going to be his first. Beaver's seventh, as we said. Culver's going to be shooting free throws here the rest of this half. A 5:07 left in the second.
Jordan Sanders will step to the line, the 5'6 guard for the Cavaliers, to shoot one of the bonus with Culver leading 20-11. 5:07 to play here in the first half. Sanders, a right-handed shooter, fires the first one. Good. He'll have one more. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Cavaliers up by 10 here with 5:07 to play in the first half. Second free throw by the seniors, no good. Kennedy skies to the board and rips it down one-handed. And out gives the head to Garrick. Alec Garrick on the right side for Rochester. 2-3 zone by the Cavalier defense. Out to Kennedy. Kennedy behind the arc, right side to Garrick. Alec with Sanders in his jersey. Spins away from the double team. Now to Abbott. Takes the pass in the lane. Jumper over. Anderson is good.
8 points for the sophomore. That's a veteran move there. He went up, and he knew Anderson was there and still was able to rise up and get over him.
Well, he learns quickly. Elliott, quick three, left corner, yep.
Speaking of veteran moves, when the other team makes a run, how about your senior player stepping up and knocking down at 16 points?
Holland for three, no good. Ball bounds around. Anderson comes down with it and steps out of bounds as he tries to save from going out of bounds. And we'll see with Rochester baseline left.
I'll tell you what, I'm really impressed with Anderson. He is all over the floor, not just a big guy who stays in the paint or tries to dunk. Every loose ball he's been on the floor, that's a hustle play where he came from underneath the rim to try to save the ball in bounds.
How much was he to help this club last year with all their heights already and their senior leadership in the backcourt? Wow.
Yeah, that's too bad because, yeah, that was the missing piece, I think. That athleticism would have been huge for the Cavs.
Kennedy at the free throw line. Fakes, gets Anderson off his feet, throws in for the jumper, no good. And Anderson with the rebound. Anderson gives off to Hansel.
Luke.
And Luke Kennedy just picked up foul number three with 4 minutes to play in the first half.
Oh, unfortunately, it's something we've become all too familiar with.
Yeah.
You know, you love the move. The shot fake got Anderson up in the air, a nice move there. But again, sometimes kids want it too much, and he's just got to learn and be better and be more of a leader than that.
Rochester wants a timeout. It's a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:07 to play in the first half. The Cavaliers up by 11 right now at Culver Community High School, 24-13.
Unfortunately, Zebra's depth is going to get tested here because the main man in the middle, Luke Kennedy, just sat down with his third foul of the game, and there's only 4:07 left in the second quarter, so he's done for an extended time. So the Medinas, the Dahlquist, those guys are going to have to to kind of help out inside because Anderson's a load. You still have Elliott inside. Zebra's down 11.
Preston Hansel, his free throw's no good, but I believe we're going to have a foul on Trent Elliott.
That's for Elliott's going to be his first, team six. So the good news for the Zebras is they will also be shooting free throws the rest of the half, so they can maybe look to be aggressive and get some points at the free throw line, get back in this game. As rough as it's been, and I think if they can get it in by 10 going into halftime, that'd be a win.
Yeah, I agree. 2-3 zone out by the Cavaliers. Holland, right side to Garrick. Garrick drives, throws up a shot over Anderson. It's no good. And the rebound to Kresik, who's back in the game for the first time. Gus Kresik, a 6'1 freshman for the Cavaliers. Elliott, wide open three. Yep. And now he's chirping at camp.
You're gonna play a zone. You cannot lose him. You've got to know where he's at all times.
He and Cam both were chirping each other coming down the court there. And then he steals the basketball. Left side. Elliott goes to the basket. No foul. Knocked away by Holland. Picked up by Garrick. Watch this coming the other way.
Nice pass.
Left hand layup by Medina is no good. The putback by Garrick is no good. Rebound tipped around. Watch this comes out of the air. And Medina is going to be fouled on the reach, and I believe, by Kresik. And that's going to send Taylor Medina to the line to shoot two.
Yep. It's going to be Kresik's first. Cavaliers seventh. So the Zebras do get a chance to score some points with the clock stop. Carter Screeton getting ready to check in.
I'm not exactly sure what Trent Elliott was doing on that layup, but he tucked that ball against his wrist like he was going to go in hard against somebody or maybe even try to go up and one-hand jam it.
He might have. I mean, this game is kind of getting that up and down, and I think there's some talk in these guys. Close enough, you know each other.
Yeah.
They're playing against each other for a while, and good move by Coach Reinhold. I think he does not want Brandon Camp to stay in that. I mean, you just have to look at the scoreboard.
Yeah.
You're down. You got to let your play speak for yourself.
Carter Screeton back into the game for Rochester as Taylor Medina hits both free throws for the Zebras to pull them within 12 with 3:15 to play in the first half. Elliott runs the point, walks it to the center circle for the Cavaliers. Down directs traffic, points to the left, looks back at Dad, gets the play.
Zebras back in half court, man-to-man.
Kruger at the free throw line, kicks it out to Elliott. Wide open three, right side. Nope, no good. The ball takes a big jump, and Anderson hauls it in. Anderson in the paint. Chip Leaner on the way is no good. And then he and Abbott on the rebound is tied up. And it'll go back to Rochester with 2:49 to play in the first half.
Typical first game, not great shooting percentages, a lot of hustle, loose ball plays. But, again, nice job by the Zebras kind of hanging in there. And now they've got a 12 score here, get it to 10.
Right.
2:45 left in the second quarter.
That'd be a pretty good moral victory right now for Rochester with the fouling situation right now. Holland, left side to Abbott. Abbott to paint. Jump pass down low to Medina. His jumper is good over Anderson.
That's a great example of Abbott passing up a good shot for a great shot. Real unselfish play for Abbott to do that. That would have been a good look, but he understood, and credit to him, he allowed Medina to have a great shot.
27-17. Elliott backs it out at the volleyball line. 2:15 to play in the first half. Over by Ken. No look pass down low to the freshman, Kresik, and he loses it right to the hand of Medina. Medina takes it away and now runs for Rochester.
That's an example there of why it's tough for guys, freshmen, to play varsity basketball because you can get away with that in an eighth grade, but at the varsity level as a freshman, games at a little different speed.
Yeah.
Abbott turns it over, but again, that's a good move. He's been the one kind of igniting the offense, not just his scoring with 8 points, but his ability to get inside and penetrate is opening up other spots for other people, and he's making the right move. He just got it off balance and traveled.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's in the paint a lot here in the first half. 10-point lead for the Cavaliers, 1:40 to play in the first half. Hansel is also Kresik. Got it. Elliott, crossover dribble, step back three, top of the key. Nope, too hard. And the rebound to Anderson. Anderson dribbles out of trouble. Now to Kruger. Kruger resets, top of the key, now drives right into paint. Kicks him to baseline. To Hansel, he'll take the 15-footer, no good. And the rebound to Garrick.
Leave a score here, get it inside double digits.
Garrick in the paint, kicks it in the corner to Abbott. 15-footer right baseline is no good, short. And the rebound to Medina. Medina comes out of there with an offensive board. Out to Holland with 1:08. Got a screen. He'll take a three left side. No good. Elliott skies in for the board and grabs and runs for the Cavaliers with 60 seconds to play in the first half. Culver up by 10. Elliott crosses the timeline against the man-to-man defense. He'll work against Garrick. Bounce pass to Anderson at the elbow. Dakota Anderson is fouled on the drive, and he'll go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Don't see that too often. Your center catches the ball and sets the guy up for a one-on-one move. We've said this before, but Anderson's been all over the place. Very, very impressed with, and they said he's not even at 100% yet. It's kind of scary to see what he'll be like when he does.
Sean Camp back into the game. Also coming into the game for the first time tonight is Matt Basham, a 5'10 senior. And coming out is Medina and Garrick. Yeah, Garrick, when they're in that man-to-man defense, throws a short straw and gets to guard Elliott. Free throw is in and out. No good by Anderson. The rebound to Basham. He gets to Streeton with 40 seconds. 27-17. Streeton at the free throw line. Kicks it out to Abbott. Down low to Basham. Basham has a shot blocked by Anderson. Schaefer going out of bounds to Holland. Now to Streeton, left corner with 30. Streeton in the paint. Outside to Abbott. Abbott at the free throw line. Stops. Leaner off the window. No good. And the ball is going to be tipped out of bounds by Dakota Anderson as he and Basham ran into each other. And the ball pops out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left.
Another good move by Abbott to get in the paint. Thought he drew a foul against Elliott, but referee said play on.
23.7 to play first half. Streeton gets it into Holland behind the arc left side. Now gives off to Camp. Camp against Culver's 2-3 zone. Ball's loose. Picked up by Elliott. And now we're going to have a foul, I believe, coming on Camp, and that's going to send Elliott to the line to shoot two.
That might have saved a fast break, though. Camp going for a loose ball. Had Elliott picked up that clean, he was going to pass ahead, and might have been an easy two for the Cavs. At least you're going to make him earn it this way, but Mr. Elliott's a good free throw shooter, right?
16.3 to play in the first half. Culver by 10. Elliott at the line for the Cavaliers for two. First one for the seniors, good.
3-3 from the line so far.
One more coming for Trent Elliott.
That's his 20th point of the game.
Jeez. Free throw no good and rebound to Basham. 28-17. Rochester looking for the final shot of the half. Abbott with 9. Back to Streeton with 8. Streeton at the paint. Has the ball tipped away and out of bounds by Elliott. It'll stay with Rochester right in front of the Cavalier bench with 6.4 to play in the first half.
The long wingspan will get you.
Yeah.
Camp was open in the corner, but Elliott was able to use his length and extend and just knock that ball out of bounds.
Streeton holds a 3. Now drives in the paint. Kicks it in the corner with 1. Holland for 3 at the buzzer is no good. At halftime, the Cavaliers lead the Zebras 28-17. You're listening to High School Guys Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Receive an instant 10 cents per gallon reward just for signing up. With every second fill-up of quality BP gasoline, you keep earning and saving 5 cents per gallon. Pick up a BP Driver Rewards brochure at your local BP to join now. Up to 20 gallons, terms and conditions apply. See bpdriverrewards.com for details.
A new dual car wash combining both soft cloth and high-pressure technology for a really clean car is coming to the Good to Go Car Wash. Purchase your wash at either Good to Go locations and save up to 20 cents per gallon on your gas purchase. Give it a try beginning November 1st.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Culver Community High School, we go to the third quarter. The Cavaliers start the third quarter of the basketball, and about that quick, they go to Dakota Anderson, who was guarded by Luke Kennedy. Anderson noticed that, Tony, and went to the basket hard and got his fifth point of the game.
Yeah, credit to him, because certainly Luke can't afford that fourth one.
Yeah.
He's going to have to be really passive in the post. Zebra's going to have to send double team to help Luke out, not put him in that situation.
30-17, the Cavaliers on top. Garrick runs the point top of the key in the paint, and he's going to be called for a charge as he leans in to Sanders and commits the charge and a turnover. Culver going to get it back.
All right, we played 40 seconds in this quarter and already 2 fouls. I think referees want to kind of clean this up. I think the game got a little physical, a little loose in the second part of the second quarter, and 2 quick fouls early trying to set the tone of the second half of, guys, let's get the physical out and let's play the game of basketball.
Alec Garrick picks up his second foul. Ball loose on the floor as a scrum, and Holland picks it up running to our right. Alec Holland for Rochester hesitates, backs his way in, shot blocked, right in the hands of Streeton. Carter Streeton dribbles high on the right side, right in front of the Rochester bench, now gives between the rings, and the center circle to Abbott, now right side to Holland. Holland to Streeton, takes a 3, drives at the elbow, kicks it out to Garrick, he'll fire a 3, it's good!
That would be a welcome sign. You get the Alec Garrick getting knocked out the outside shot, that's another weapon to loosen up that defense.
Kerger in the right corner on the baseline, between his legs dribble, has a pass going to Holland. Holland, left side of the floor, goes into the layup. The putback no good by Garrick. And the baseball pass ahead to Anderson. Bounce pass to Elliott. And before the pass, we're going to have a travel.
His eyes got big. It was a situation where he was thinking about what he was going to do with it before he actually caught it. He knew he had Elliott streaking down the other sideline, and he was looking for a quick pass and maybe a dunk, but shuffled his feet as he was trying to make that delivery.
I was going to say, we've already seen one Cavalier hanging off the rim already tonight. We don't know if we need to see another one.
Culver coming out a little bit of a trap, kind of 1-2-2-3-2.
Alec Garrett goes strong to the basket. He is he misses the shot. Kennedy with the rebound. His putback, he's fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's a good sign because he put three guys out on the perimeter trapping. You only got two guys back, even though one of them is Anderson. Gives Luke some room to work and get an offensive putback. Let's see if he can get on the scoreboard here today.
Well, you talk about Culver trying to tighten up. Like, that's the first time we saw that defensive work.
Yeah, again, this is their first game, too, trying to get some different things on tape, seeing what's working, and you know, the scoreboard is nice to have a lead, but trying to extend it if you can.
So, with it being the first game and being there up by 10, they treat this now kind of like a practice?
Well, not necessarily, yeah. I mean, the game's not done by any stretch, but you've got some things you probably wanted to work on, and with a 10-point lead, you might be able to experiment a little bit, understanding that if things don't go well, you can always go back to what you were doing before.
Kennedy hits one of two. Kruger at the baseline. Has his pass tipped away and actually tipped off of him and out of bounds. Going to go back to Rochester, who are down by 9 now with 6:08 to play in the third quarter.
You know, we played a couple minutes. Culver's only got 2 points this quarter. The Zebras have gotten some turnovers. They just need to convert it. The Zebras have outscored them 4-2. Got to keep chipping away at this lead.
Holland high on the left side, 2-3 zone by the Cavaliers. Now to Garrick between the rings. Left side to Streeton. Streeton against Sanders. Baseline to Holland. Kicks it out to Kennedy. Kennedy at the free throw line. His jumper is short off the front of the rim, off the backboard, and in.
Third point of the quarter for Luke. That's a great sign, like you said. If he can knock down that 15-footer, the defense is going to have to respect that.
Culver's lead is touch of 7. 2-3 zone by the Zebras. And now we're going to have a 3-second violation against the Cavaliers. And Coach Elliott will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Get smooth one coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Enyard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5:32 to play in the third quarter, Stays, and you get the feeling that momentum is beginning to switch a little.
Yeah, it is. Zebras just chipped away. You know, they've got some turnovers. They've been able to get some scores. Luke Kennedy's in scoring column with 3 points this quarter. Alec Garrick hit a big three-pointer. Zebras have got it down to 7. Momentum's on the side. Score here, keep building on momentum, and you know, see what happens. But you're right back in the ball game. You got to get a conversion here this trip and get things really tight.
So Streeton with the basketball, man-to-man, 2-3 zone by the Cavaliers. And Streeton throws it out of bounds. So with 5:23 to play in the third, Cavaliers going to get it back. Now only up by 7.
Tough angle for a post feed. You'd probably like a couple more dribbles, get more to the wing, and then feed that high post to Luke.
2-3 zone with the Zebra defense. Streeton comes out of the volleyball line to meet Sanders. Sanders gives it outside to Kruger. His jumper from on at the three-point line is good. And the lead is back to 9 for the Culver Cavaliers. Street high on the left side. Man-to-man defense by the Cavaliers now as Garrick has it right side against Elliott. Bounce pass to Street. Street against Sanders. Drives right. Goes to baseline. His leaning pass can be waved off. And we're going to have a travel before the pass. It'll be out of bounds to the Cavaliers.
Yeah, that situation, I think Carter thought he had a drive, and then Mr. Anderson came over and he caught it and didn't have time to adjust to plan B or C and shuffle his feet and turn the ball over.
Elliott high on the right side, man-to-man, 2-3 zone by the Zebra defense, pardon me. Sanders gets to Elliott in the volleyball line. Back to Sanders, now left side to Anderson. Anderson, look at Sanders, you see the back door.
Yeah, they were trying to set it up this time from Anderson to Elliott.
This is exactly what they were running last time. Anderson got the backdoor alley-oop jam. As he goes hard to the basket, throws the shot over Elliott, makes that to Kennedy to go. And Culver back by 11 with 4:17 to play in the third. Abbott out to Streeton. Now to Garrett between the rings. Taylor Medina checking in the next opportunity for Rochester. Brett Abbott for Rochester. Dribbles top of the key against the man-to-man defense. Works against Kruger right side to Streeton. Baseline to Garrett. He takes a jumper over Elliott. It's in and out and back in. 34-25.
Garrett's got five in the quarter as well. Two seniors taking over for Rochester. Garrett with five this quarter. Candidate with three.
2-3 zone by the Zebras. Kruger has it near the Culver bench. There's Lake dribbled on the left side behind the arc. Now gives the Sanders in the center circle. 3.5 playing the third. Culver by 9. Sanders around the double team. Inside the arc in the baseline. Wrap around pass is knocked out of bounds by Garrick. And it's going to stay with the Cavaliers baseline to the left. Medina back into the game, and Kennedy will set with three personal fouls.
This is where he got, yeah, coach has just got to manage it. He's played well. He bought some minutes, but you don't want him to commit that fourth and then really change game plan. Good, solid run there for Luke, and got the Zebras back in the game.
The lob pass goes into Anderson. While in flight, puts it in for two and pushes the Cavaliers' lead back to 11.
Anderson has six this quarter, 9 for the game.
Garrett, who has 5 points this quarter, works right side to Abbott behind the arc right in front of Coach Reinholdt. Down the paint, stops, leaner, is good, and a foul.
Nice job, Brett Abbott. Reaches double figures. Nice move by him, attacking the paint as he did so many times in the first half. Foul's going to be on Everett Kruger. That's his first, team's third. And Abbott's going to go to the line, try to get 11.
Brett Abbott to the line to shoot one. He makes this one. Noah Dahlquist will come in for him. Abbott, the sophomore, sets himself, fires a free throw. It rattles around and goes. 36-28. Dahlquist in, Abbott out. The first double-digit score of the night for the Rochester Sabres.
Very impressed with Abbott. The coach certainly has. The first game is looking for answers to a lot of questions, and I think he definitely found a nice, solid answer in Brett Abbott on the offensive end, regardless of what happens the rest of the way.
Tony Stasiak on David Musselman. 2-3 zone by the Zebra defense. Sanders works left side after 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Rochester down by 8. Kruger down the right side. Now back to Anderson. A couple of dribbles to Hansel. Now to Elliott against on the baseline, and he's going to be fouled going to the basket by Taylor Medina, I believe. It'll be out of bounds to Culver baseline left with 2:37 to play in the third quarter.
Medina's second, only the Zebras' second foul of the quarter. Good matchup for Medina. There's no easy matchups when you're guarding Trent Elliott for the
right.
Zebras, but I think Medina's an interesting one. Soccer player, he's got good feet, and maybe keep it Elliott in front of him.
Elliott shoots the inbounds pass. As that one just looked like a moment ago, as we saw the inbound pass come to Anderson, who rises up. Did Elliott grabs the ball before coming down, shoots it in midair, and just about got it to go for a shot, but he'll go to the line to shoot two after the foul.
Nice luxury for Culver to have Elliott and on those out of bounds plays underneath, screen for each other, and then
they
both
jump.
Get a lob off the inbound pass.
Elliott makes the first free throw. He'll have one more, looking to push this lead back to 10 for the Cavaliers. He does so.
After a 20-point first half, Elliott's first 2 points of the second half.
2.5 to play third quarter. Taylor Medina just picked up foul number 4. And Alec Garrick chucks it in the stand. Well, we're going to get it back. Coming back in is Alex Graham, and sitting down is Hansel with the Cavs.
Yeah, this is that these last 2 minutes of this quarter, really important. You had it down to 7 at one point. Now it's back to 10. You want to keep this inside double digits heading into the fourth. You don't want to let this get to a 15-point spread heading into the fourth.
It is 10 right now, 38-28 in the corner to Elliott. Elliott feeds down low to Anderson. Anderson in the paint, goes to the basket, foul the shot. Good play to shoe. How about that entry pass?
Nice pass and good post move. Decisive post move by Anderson. Dahlquist is going to pick up his first.
Tough pass to handle, and I thought Anderson showed nice soft hands to grab that and bring it in.
Yeah, that was not an easy pass to handle, but Anderson continues to impress with his ability to work around the post.
Dakota Anderson makes another free throw and pushes the lead back to 11 for the Cavaliers with one more coming. 2:12 to play in the third quarter.
Just reached double figures. He's got 10.
Free throw short. Garrett grabs the board.
7 this quarter.
Now Garrett to the center circle. 2-3 zone, I believe. Maybe man-to-man. I don't know. High on the left side is Holland. At the elbow to Thomas. Back to Camp. Camp against Sanders. Sweeney's late dribble at the elbow. Out to Holland for three. Off the back of the iron, no good. Derrick with the rebound, back to the way in. Throws him a shot over the double team, and he's going to be fouled on the shot. And he'll go to the line to shoot two, and I believe Anderson, maybe Elliott.
Foul's going to be an Anderson, his second, team's fourth.
1:48 to play in the third quarter. Alec Garrick will go to the line to shoot two for his Zebras. Down by 11. First one on the way for the seniors. Good. Brett Abbott will come back into the game for Rochester after this, well, must be coming in for Garrick if he makes his free throw. 10-point lead for the Cavs. Garrick looking to cut this to 9. The free throw high off the back of the iron, and Anderson skies the board and gives to Sanders. 2-3 zone by the Zebras. Sanders around the defense, inside the arc. Bounce pass to Anderson. Kicks it out to Kruger for 3. Left baseline is short. Put back by Elliott's good. 41-29. Over on top with a minute 25 to play in the third. 2-3 zone now by Cavaliers. Camp in the right baseline. Jump pass to Dahlquist. Down low to Thomas. Dom has a shot blocked from behind by Anderson. And out of bounds. It will stay with Rochester underneath the rim basket as Brett Abbott comes back into the game. And sitting down is Garrick.
Two guys making their first real varsity experience debut here. Dahlquist and Thomas had a nice look there playing that high-low game. Dahlquist made a nice catch on the high elbow and then nice bounce pass. Yep. Thomas shot fake and attempted to draw a foul.
Holland looks to get it in. No look pass into Abbott. Behind the arc, right between the rings. The Camp for 3, right side, throws nothing but air and out of bounds. And the Cavaliers will...
Zebras need to stop here. Got it.
Minute 7 to play in the third quarter.
Taking about full court, looks like a little 2-2-1 trap.
Sanders gets it across the timeline, right side, now inside the arc. Wrap around pass to Anderson. His layup is good. That looked easy.
Yeah, well, when your traps aren't there and slow to rotate, you give layups, and Mr. Anderson was a beneficiary of that.
Camp drives, has a shot, a ball tripped away, and he's going to be fouled on the shot, and that's going to send Sean Camp to the line to shoot two. I'm sorry, Brandon Camp to the line to shoot two for the Zebras.
Foul's going to be on Sanders, his third, team's fifth. Zebras are 5 of 7 from the line tonight. This is Camp's first appearance at the line.
Did you really outshoot Cass the other night, 30-2?
Yes, that's a fact.
Free throw by Camp is good.
Well, here's the deal. We shot 42 shots. Only 6 of them were outside the paint. They chucked up 23 threes. So.
That still doesn't explain how, well, yeah, it does.
It was not a Rochester.
The paint a lot.
Yes, that's right.
And that was on the road. That's
that
even more
was on the road, yes.
Brandon Camp with one more, the 5'8 senior. Buys the second one, flies it. Good. 43-31, over on top by 12, with 45 seconds to play in the third. Winnipeg on Saturday.
Yep.
At home.
At home, big rivalry game. Hope to see a big crowd.
Absolutely, that'd be great.
Two teams playing pretty good basketball.
Bring some leftover turkey, that'd be perfect. Down low to a wide open handful, right handed layup is good. Well, when you get sucked in for looking at 23-21, you kind of lose track of the others, and Hansel was the beneficiary of that.
Those guys should have decent years because as much attention as Anderson and Elliott are going to get, if those guys can just hang around the blocks, they'll get a lot of layups.
All right. Thomas gets the entry pass from Abbott, backs his way in, throws him a shot, and short, gets a rebound back. The putback is good with 9 seconds. Nice hard work by Dom Thomas down low with 6. Elliott behind his back, dribble with 4. Crosses the timeline of 3. Works left side with 2. Pull up jumper from 18 feet. Is in and out. No good at the buzzer. After 3, the Cavaliers lead by 12 at 45-33. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Local people making a big difference when it comes to insurance needs. Insurance does not have to be complicated. That's why Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance are your local trusted choice agent. They have access to multiple insurance carriers that offer competitive pricing and individual coverage. Call 574-223. 1-800-253-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
Take the leap into online bill pay with First Federal Savings Bank. Online bill pay is the easier, faster, and safer way to pay all your bills. Hop into the convenience of paying all your bills from one secure website and gain greater control over both your time and your finances. With First Federal's online bill pay, you get control of being able to change, edit, or stop pending payments. You'll have the convenience of paying anyone who you would normally pay by check, and you can manage all of your payments from one location. Log in to your online banking account at www.firstfederalbanking.com and jump in today. First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th Street, Rochester, and 814 North US 35 in Winnemac. FDIC insured, equal housing lender.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth and final quarter here at Culver Community High School. The Zebras down by 12 at 45-33. Holland, baseline to Abbott. Abbott, floater over Anderson's block. Picked up by Treaton in the paint. Jump pass outside to Kennedy, who's back in the basketball game. Goes defense to Holland near the sideline. Holland, a one dribble. Now we'll set things up again for Rochester. Top of the key against the 2-3 zone.
Interesting look putting Elliott at the top. Kind of harass some shooters, use his length. Coach Reinhold take a timeout to kind of draw up a plan of attack against it.
And it'll be a 60. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's tables since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
It's just nonsense the way some water softener companies claim electricity is the only thing that matters when it comes to better water. Culligan embraces technology. Their water softeners use $3 a year in electricity. That $3 a year powers their smart sensor, the brain of the softener, so it recharges only when needed. That means you don't waste salt or water the way brainless non-electric softeners do. Start saving today by calling Culligan of Fulton County, 574-223-2420, and trying the smarter solution to hard water for only $10 a month. Culligan, better water, pure and simple.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
7:28 to play in the game. The Rochester Zebras trail the Culver Cavaliers here at Culver Community High School, 45-33.
Zebras had a good third quarter scoring, 16 points in the third after a half of 17 points. Problem is they gave up 17 in the third quarter Culver, so Culver extended their lead by one. Zebras down 12.
Yeah, you know, they had to have that third quarter to keep pace. It could be ugly at this point if they didn't have that big quarter.
And it could have been tighter. Remember, they cut it down to 7 at one point.
Right.
They were right there, and it kind of got away from them. A couple quick stops and scores here can call right back in it, but they've got to get that offense going and get some stops, particularly against Elliott and Anderson on the other end.
Yeah, they've got the majority of their points.
Elliott has 24, Anderson has 12.
Kennedy just inside the arc, long jumper short. And Garrick hauls the rebound in and bangs it off the leg of Anderson as he's falling out of bounds. And so it goes off of Culver and out of bounds. Rochester keep possession right in front of their bench.
Good hustle play by Garrick. Didn't quite have possession, so he threw it off Anderson's foot to retain possession for the Z's.
6:40 to play in the basketball game. 45-33. The Cavaliers lead. Street bounce pass to Holland on the left side. Now to Garrick behind the arc. Drives around Elliott in the lane. His floater on the way is no good, but a foul coming on the Cavaliers.
Good move to the basket. It's going to foul on Trent Elliott. That's his third, team six. The Zebras will shoot free throws the rest of the way.
And that was before the shot. So it'll be the Zebra basketball out of bounds, baseline right. Kennedy gets it into Garrick. Now to Holland high on the right side. Alec Holland had a nice, first or second quarter, and he's been kind of quiet here in the second half.
Yeah, he has not scored in the second half after 5 points in the first half.
Garrick to Screeton. High on the left side to Holland. In the middle to Abbott. His leader is partially blocked. Ball loose, picked up by Anderson. Anderson crossed the pass to Elliott, and somehow Elliott got the basket to go. He was fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot one. Elliott just threw that thing up for prayer, and it found the bottom of the basket.
Foul's going to be on Alec Holland trying to stop the fast break, but didn't quite get enough to stop him from scoring. That's one of those plays you might see on SportsCenter later on tonight.
Gee.
So back into the game is Basham, and Abbott will sit. Also back into the Cavaliers is Graham. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman, and Trent Elliott at the line to try to complete the three-point play. As he does so, with a free throw. Now the lead is 15 for the Cavs. Screen between the rings, right side to Holland. Lolland has it sent off his foot. Out of bounds, going to go back to Culver.
I don't know if he meant to do that. If he did, it's a really heady play because not only did he get the deflection, but as he got the swipe, he swiped down and went right off Holland's shoe. Good position for Cavs. He's coming out in the 2-2-1 half-court trap.
Graham, jump pass across the timeline to Hansel. Now to Elliott. Elliott then has it pass tipped away by Kennedy, who gives it to Street. Rochester runs to our right. Down by 15, and Street throws it behind Garrick and out of bounds.
That was a good defensive possession by Z's. Fortunately, he couldn't capitalize. This is a defense they've been working on a little bit. I think it's, you know, you're at that point, you're down 15, you gotta kind of pull out the stops here and get some turnovers and hopefully some transition buckets. But these were better on the rotation that last time down.
And here's that defense you were talking about just a moment ago. Elliott, layup, good. That passing over the head of Kennedy, and there was nobody between Elliott and the basket. He goes up for an easy two. Street up the floor.
Knocking on the door, 30th, 29.
Yeah, 50-33. Culver on top, 5:25 to play in the game. Kennedy has his pass tipped away and stolen by Anderson. Anderson, middle of the floor, jump pass to a Graham, and he is fouled, and that's going to send, nope, it's not going to send Culver. Next foul, Will. He'll be out of bounds with the Cavs.
Charter Street, second.
I'm impressed with Anderson. You know, for a big man, he runs the floor like a guard, looking around to see who could, he can pass that to. And
yeah, how many five guys, you know, centers, whatever you want to call them, can get a loose ball, handle the ball in traffic, make good passes, finish with a dunk. And I mean,
yeah,
those two, him and Elliott, you can tell they're both seniors, play a lot of basketball together. They work really, really well together. They're going to be headaches for more teams in the Zebras,
yeah, right,
as the year goes on.
Culver loses it out of bounds, so Rochester will get it back. 50-33, Culver, 5 minutes to play in the game. Street against the 2-3 zone. Picks up a dribble behind the arc at the free throw line to Kennedy. Turnaround jumper for the Zebras is no good. And Elliott with the board, he has loses it through his hands. And it goes out of bounds off of Elliott, and the Cavaliers will stay with Rochester.
Zebras were fortunate that Elliott couldn't find the handle because they all five Zebras came in rebound. Nobody got back, and Anderson was starting to streak down the floor. If Elliott could have handled that, we might have seen another two.
Yeah. And the entry pass goes to Garrick, and he's fouled immediately by Graham, and that's going to send Alec Garrick to the line for one of the bonus.
Foul's going to be on Graham. His third, team seventh. Zebras scoring with the clock stopped. Always going to be important. You got to hit your free throws. 5 of 7. 7 of 9 for the Z's on the game so far.
Garrick, first one. Good. We'll have one more. Alec Garrick is a 6'2 senior for the Rochester Zebras. One more coming. Second is in and out and back in.
8 points for Garrick.
Garrick approaching the double-digit mark. Abbott's the only one there, correct?
Yep. Zebras still in that 2-2-1, trying to get their rotations down and get the turnovers, which they do. Camp at the steal.
Camp goes in for the layup and shot good and a foul. Well, you heard Coach Elliott say in the pregame where we've got to develop some guards, and you can see why right there.
Yeah, the Zebras, the rotations as they're getting this 2-2-1 down are much crisper, much cleaner, more aggressive with those traps, and hands are active, getting deflections, which lead to steals, and this is the kind of basketball I think Camp can specialize in. Quick guard, made a good read, and finished, and hopefully get the and one.
So Camp eyes it, flies it, and the lead is set to 12. Full court press now by the Zebras.
Camp with 5 and a perfect freeze in the line.
Kruger gets it into Sanders. He works against Camp in the backcourt. Sanders.
Nice pressure. Nice pressure by Camp.
Gets up the ball. Foul. And now Coach Elliott will use a timeout. And it will be a full timeout. 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible, low-income households. A subscriber that meets criteria as established by the Indiana Utility Regulatory Commission and lives within the Rochester Telephone Company service area must be a participant in one of the following programs to qualify for the Lifeline benefit: Medicaid, food stamps, supplementary security income, federal public housing assistance, low-income home energy program, temporary assistance to needy families, national school lunch free program, and income-based federal eligibility. Only one Lifeline benefit per household is allowed. For more information, or to see if you qualify for Lifeline assistance, please call Rochester Telephone Company at 223-2191.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:38 to play in the game. The Cavaliers up by 12, 50-38. And Val Sinceris, the sports editor of the Rochester Sentinel, has some scores for us.
Yeah, thanks to Val for getting us these scores. Local interest, especially here at halftime. Warsaw Tigers 5, Valley Vikings 21. So that's rivalry games going on here. You got Logan Sport and Peru. Logan Sport was up big at halftime of that one. So this is neat. It's kind of the night before Thanksgiving. It's always tradition. You know that the high school boys season really gets going the night before Thanksgiving. So some basketball tonight. And turkey and football tomorrow.
Any basketball tomorrow?
Oh, I'm sure. Oh, yeah, there's always, was it Anaheim on Disney? Somewhere there's, I think there's some.
Anderson picks up a loose ball. He goes into the basket. He dunks over Derek, two-hand jam. Second one of the night for Anderson. And it's back to 16-point lead. That'll make that 14.
If he keeps doing that, some college is going to come calling for him, too.
Well, yeah.
That's not a fast break. That's a one-on-one move that you finish with a dunk.
Basham has his shot blocked. Elliott, right side behind the back pass to Kruger, goes off his hands, through his hands out of bounds, and it'll go back to the Sabres.
I tell you what, I've known Coach Elliott for a lot of years. Really respect the job he does, and I know how he wants to play basketball, and I know the feeling, too, when it's your kid. But, you know, that behind-the-back pass at the turnover is going to drive him nuts. I can imagine that car ride home.
Cam,
myself.
The double team in the corner has tipped away and stolen by Anderson. And off the hand, stolen back by Kerrig. He goes out of bounds off of Culver. And the Zebras will have it in front of their own bench.
Zebras have an all-senior lineup right now. Their five seniors are all on the floor. We're putting in the seniors' hands, see what they can do. Unfortunately, Garrett with the travel gives the ball back to the Cavs.
Keaton, fortunately for her, will be driving next year, or soon, maybe this year. She may not have to listen to...
Oh, I don't know. I don't think that's going to stop until she drives. I need that drive home.
Yeah. Fortunately,
that's right. Fortunately for us, we don't live very far from the school. it's fun, though. I can really appreciate what Coach Elliott is going through, and I heard you talking to him about senior year, and I started thinking, wow, I can't even begin to imagine what that point's going to be like, but I know Coach Elliott is going to have a good rapport, and that is an interesting thing. It's a neat dynamic as a coach to be able to coach a kid. It's some tough times, but it's kind of neat, too.
Well, I don't know how, and maybe you don't, but I don't know how you separate home and gym. There's no way I could do that.
When we hit the door, the conversation's over. And you just have to, you know, that's the way it is. And I'm sure Coach Elliott would say the same thing. We have good kids, and that's the fun of it. But, you know, you have to be able to separate that.
That'd be one of those things, watching film. I'd be just like, Kennedy, come down here. We need to talk about this. Elliott makes both free throws for the Cavaliers, 54-38. Culver. 3:35 to play in the game.
31 for Mr. Elliott.
And Brett Abbott just gets out of bounds because of the double-team pressure.
Speaking of film sessions, this is going to be one Coach Reinhold's going to really want to use. There's a lot of things. There's flashes of good things, but there's some things where they're not that far away, but there's some certain mistakes that once these guys see that on film, as they say, the eye in the sky doesn't lie. Once they see these things, they'll be able to clean some of this stuff up.
Ball goes in to Elliott. And he goes in hard to the basket. He's going to be fouled on the shot. I believe Kennedy just picked up foul number 4.
Looks like a good play. But again, as the game has gone on, kind of like it did at the end of the first half, it's gotten kind of sloppy. It's gotten kind of physical. The referees certainly don't want this to get too far out of hand, so they have a little bit of a tight whistle here down the stretch.
So back to the free throw line is Trent Elliott looking to add to his 30-plus points. Senior's free throw is in and out, no good. dad chirping at him. He's going to have those free throws. And now Coach Ryan Hull will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
You guys ready for the game?
All right. Well, management told me they weren't paying me for pep talks, so I'm going to stop now.
You know that place between saving money and sacrificing quality?
We are so there.
What's the point of saving money if you get lousy results, especially when it comes to car insurance? State Farm can give you the right amount of coverage, plus with discounts up to 40%. You'll like how much you can save. State Farm is there.
That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank.
Discounts may vary 5 to 40% state to state.
Yeah!
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3:15 to play in the game. Cavaliers leading 54-38. It'll be Rochester Basketball on the far sideline. 2-3 zone by the Cavs. Street directs traffic, sits high to the left side to Abbott. Abbott holds above his head, and we're going to have a foul away from the basketball. Is that going to be on Elliott?
Either the moving screen or fighting through the screen. One of the two.
That's right, Elliott. Picked up foul number three and just about got teed up in the meantime.
That's also a different conversation that a coach who's a parent can have versus that. And that's the best way to send a message. It's sitting down sends a pretty big message.
And that's exactly what he's doing as Alec Graham comes back into the game.
Credit to Coach Elliott. And, you know, I think Trent's better than that as well. And he'll learn lessons. Because certainly early on, you're going to see these guys and you want to play the game the right way and, you know, let your play do the talking for you.
Taylor hits the first free throw. He'll have one more for the Zebras. 3:07 to play in the game. Over up 54-39. Second by Patina's no good. Graham with the rebound. And now gives to Sanders. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman.
Zebras back in that 2-2-1 half-court. No, it's more of a 1-3-1. This is a 1-3-1 half-court trap.
Kruger in the lane. Down low to Anderson. Layup is good. Nice ball move by the Cavaliers to find a wide open Anderson. He's got two more, and it's 56-39.
16 for the game for Anderson. Elliott with 31.
Pass is knocked away, but right back to the hands of Holland. Now to screen high on the right side. Screen, crossover dribble. It's a free throw line out to Holland. Alec, above his head, gives to Medina at the free throw line. Medina drives, and he's going to be called for travel.
That's the right idea. Again, that's something else. Is he get more reps trying that move? That'll be very effective for him as either a finish or a kick out to a guard. But that's one where feet got a little ahead of him.
Yeah. So Culver with the basketball again.
Back to the 2-2-1 half-court trap.
That pass comes down to Sanders somehow. He gets into the corner to Kruger. And Kruger loses the basketball off his leg and out of bounds. And they are in disarray without 21 on the floor.
That's true, man. When the guy does as much as he is, you can certainly see why. Zebra's got to build on this, get a couple scores. Get the score back more respectable.
17-point lead for the Cavs. Kennedy to elbow, out the street, who drives in the corner to Holland. Holland now brings to the right wing. 2-3 zone by the Cavs. Top of the key to Abbott. Quickly left side to Streeton. Back to Abbott between the rings. Red holds at the volleyball line. Right side to Kennedy. He'll take a three right side. Good!
Hey, how about that, huh? Big man stepping out and knocking down three. Now you get a three. You get Luke Kennedy knocking down threes. Now you have a whole different dynamic for the Rochester offense.
56-42. Minute 35 to play in the game. In the corner to Kruger. Near the sideline. Tries to force the pass in. Stolen by Streeton. Streeton middle of the floor. He'll go outside to Abbott on the baseline. Brett drives, kicks it out to Kennedy. Another three on the way, right side. Good again!
Hey, maybe we found something here, huh?
And the Cavaliers will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Minute 18 to play in the game. Rochester Zebras will have it. Culver will have it after the Culver timeout. And, you know, Stace, you said something there in the break. Even though Culver's been up as much as 16, now they're only up by 11. But Coach Kyle Elliott was getting after him, but you said it's not always about this game.
Yeah, sometimes about next game. And teams that have high standards for themselves, when you might have a comfortable win, says, hey, let's just finish this, that's okay. But, you know, if you've got good expectations and high expectations, you should play every minute the way it should be played and finish games with an exclamation point and not a question mark.
Sanders just about stepped on the timeline. He gives to Kruger, down low to Anderson, and Anderson's fouled on the reach in by Medina. And Taylor Medina just fouled out with 56 seconds to play in the game.
Solid start for Medina coming off the bench. Ended up 3-4 from line and a 2-point field goal, so he's got 5 points.
Back into the game is Derek, and have it back in as well. Coming out of the street.
Oh, by the way, what a difference it makes when number 21 came back into the game for Culver to handle the Zebras' pressure as well. Probably that helped.
So at the line is Jakuta Anderson. The first free throw by the big man is good. They'll have one more. 56 seconds to play in the game. Culver up by 12. One more coming for Anderson. Second one's good again.
I know he talked about this off the air, too. If he keeps this up, there's going to be some colleges that are coming to call.
Yeah.
I think right now they're on hold as he's recovering from injury, but if he can keep this up, he's going to play somewhere, and he certainly should. Very impressed with how he's played all around tonight.
Shot by Garrick is so good. Elliott in the middle of the floor. Elliott goes to the basket. Right-handed layup is good. On that rebound, they missed a streaking Anderson down the floor, or we just need another dunk.
Yeah, 33 for Elliott.
30 seconds, 15-point lead for Culver. Have it, right side to Garrick. Drives, stops, reverse layup is no good. Elliott with the rebound. And Coach Elliott says, nah, just slow down. 15 seconds to play in the game. Culver going to start their season 1-0. Rochester's got Plymouth Tech, and they'll face the Pilgrims with an 0-1 record. Elliott dribbles to the timeline. That's going to do it. The final tonight from Culver Community High School. Culver Cavaliers 60, Zebras 45. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by...